Hi, welcome to Software PE Team. I'm Jonas Lindholm, and in this video I will tell you about the functionality Virtual Breakout Board that was introduced in PlusOne Guide 2022.3. What is the PlusOne Virtual Breakout Board concept? The VBB concept enables you to run your PlusOne Guide application in a virtual environment on your development PC, where you don't have or don't want to use physical PlusOne hardware controllers, displays, etc. The feature is introduced in version 2022.3 of PlusOne Guide and Service Tool. The VBB concept includes a new mode of a PlusOne Service Tool called Virtual Mode. This is the virtual breakout board that you use the new P1 instrument bus for, connecting to the virtual hardware components, input and output signals. It also includes a virtual CAN gateway and a new gateway connection in PlusOne Service Tool to connect to the virtual gateway. It's a lot of technical components, so let's start with an example instead. In the picture, you can see the T1 training kit that contains one DM430, one breakout box, T1, power supply, and a USB cable to connect the kit to a PC running PlusOne Service Tool. Let us quick look how to download a program and show the basic usage of the T1 breakout box. I start by selecting gateway to connect to the DM430. I use DM430 plus CAN0. Next step is to load the DM430 with my dual path application. When the application is loaded, I use the menu buttons to go to the dual path screen. Now turning port 1 and port 2 will result in me affecting the propel and steer input to the application. We can see the bar graph for the output moving. They represent the forward and backward operation of the left and right hydraulic motor on the excavator. On the computer, you can see the service tool with a service tool application showing the excavator and the band or motor movement. We can also see how the buttons lit up. Now, let's go to the new feature and do the same debugging using the new virtual functions. We will use the exact same application as we did when using the physical T1 training kit. Let's open up the dual path application in PlusOne Guide. I already now want to highlight an important setting for the display in the screen editor. For the visual part, this setting is crucial, but for the physical part, it's not so important. Double click on any one of the screen definitions to open up the screen editor. Then select skin, and then select the proper skin layout. In this case, the navigation buttons. It is important to choose the correct design, as we now in the virtual mode have input signals on the buttons. We need to build the application for debug, so let's start to do so. Now running in debug mode, you will see the new system under test viewer. In this case, showing under DM430 application with the skin we selected earlier. Let's test how to use the system under test viewer. I will click on the navigation buttons the same way as I do on the physical DM430. Let's go to the dual path page. We can already now see the PlusOne virtual CAN gateway has started for the system we started to debug. You can see the application name, which is the same as the description for the application ID. The debug functions are the same as before, so I will not focus particularly on them. Please watch the PlusOne Guide debugging and testing playlist on our YouTube channel for more information. However, The new feature is able to virtually connect to the hardware input and output signals by using the so-called instrument bus. Let's take a look at the virtual breakout board now. We start an instance of the service tool. We select virtual mode from the drop-down list at the bottom of the service tool or on the communication menu and then the alternative virtual or by using the button at the bottom in the gateway dialog. The service tool connects to the application running in the debug mode by using the P1 instrument bus. Now we can build a service tool layout, the so-called P1D file, for the virtual breakout board. I recommend to create an advanced parameters page and make it clear visible that this is a breakout board page to distinguish it from a normal service screen that we later will see when we like to debug. Now let us test and see how we can connect from the virtual breakout board to the virtualized input pins in the +1 guide running the application in debug mode. What have we done so far? I have demonstrated the use case of debugging a +1 guide application without the need for electronic hardware. But it doesn't stop there. With VBB, you can do more than you can do with the physical breakout box T1. You can also control view internal variables through the set value and checkpoint, etc., without the need to have an additional service tool connected. If we want to focus more on a simulation without the need for debugging in +1 guide, we can start the application under test by running the .exe file in the debug folder. When you select run for an application in +1 guide, there is a debug folder created at the same folder the project is stored. Go to the folder and search for the .exe file that has the same name as the application. Double-click the .exe file. Now we can debug the display application by using the virtual breakout board we did earlier. It's of course possible to use the +1 guide in debug mode, but this is much easier and faster way to start the app on your PC. I move the slider for the propel and steer direction, and we can see the outputs on the simulated display. We can also lit the diodes on the display by using the switches on the virtual breakout board. Now I would like to show you how you can debug and test the service tool application by connecting the virtual app on your PC. I start by opening up another instance of the service tool, run it in online mode and select the +1 virtual CAN gateway as the interface to my system under test application. The application DM430 node 23 use the virtual CAN 0, so I select that one in the menu and click OK. Now you can see the +1 virtual CAN gateway says service tool connected. So let's move the slide bars to the virtual breakout board to simulate the turn of the potentiometer of the physical T1 kit. A lot of functionality you can do on the virtual environment. I would say most of what is available on the physical system or real electronics hardware. However, it will lead too long to mention all of them in this video. Instead, I would like to focus on an application where we can communicate between two T1 training kits over CAN bus. Let's return to the physical kits to show where the setup we want to mimic with our virtual setup. First step is the same step we do in the training, and that is change so the two kits match the sending and receiving CAN address so they don't clash. We also need to have different node addresses set for the service tool. We start by copying the project to a new folder and rename it. Don't forget to change the application ID. Here we call it node 24. Now we can program load the new Node 24 display with the new digital project. I press the navigation keys to go to the dual path menu. Let us also test the application that I downloaded to the Node 24 display by turning the potentiometers knobs. Connect the CAN bus on the CAN kit together with banana cables. I will now also test the Node 23, that is the direct connection to control the excavator, like you can see here. And now I will turn on the remote setting, so I will control the excavator now from the Node 24's breakout box by turning the knobs here, like you can see. And we are sending the commands over the CAN bus. Now let's repeat this for the virtual setup. If we have already done it, compile and run both the Node 23 and the Node 24 projects to create the .exe files in the debug folder. This time I'm not interested in doing a debug, so we execute both .exe files. Otherwise I had executed one application and run the other one in debug mode on the plus one guide. We can see the two applications are now connected to the virtual CAN gateway. Here you see I got an error message saying I'm already have a virtual service tool running. So I start the service tool in online mode instead. I connect to the virtual channel 0, where my DM430 application are communicating. I open up the service tool application for the excavator, testing the joystick function as well as the remote control function on the virtual breakout board. Then I start the service tool application and start using the joystick to control the excavator. Now I switch to remote control by changing the set value in the Node 23 application. We can see the excavator is now controlled by the remote control. We can also use the CAN monitor to analyze the CAN messages sent between the two nodes. With this last example of debugging a system, I hope you get the first idea of what the new virtual breakout board function can be used for. For more information on PlusOne software, please remember to visit our forum or help desk, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see our latest video releases. Thank you for listening.